For seafood, for freshwater fish business, this is the best location because we have the two rivers confluence. We have Mississippi River, Ohio River, and also we have two big lakes, Kentucky Lake and the Barkley Lake, full of Asian carps, you know, which cause a big problem here. But in the world, there is a big demand of this fish. And the government, they spend a lot of effort and they encourage us to process, get more fish. We have got a 6 years program, and in 6 years, I will move 78 million pounds of fish, Asian carp, from, you know, the waterways here.
One thing that has the ability to reduce the numbers of carp is commercial fishing. That has been a successful tool to this point to remove fish. You'll see people electrofish with our boats, carp, and catch great numbers in some places, certain times of the year. But on average, the commercial harvest is far more economical and productive. One of the ways that we've been able to transition commercial fishermen from fishing for, say, catfish or buffalo fish is to Asian carp is through the Asian Carp Harvest Incentive Program. The program started not 10 months ago, I guess, and we've already had 1.2 million pounds taken out within that program. Over the last 4 years, we were talking about tens of thousands, then hundreds of thousands, and now we're talking about millions of pounds coming out of this lake. And the fish come in every day with the opening and closing of the locks, but, you know, at some point we think we can get enough pressure on them to get their numbers down to minimize the impact.
Asian carp are very sensitive to sound, more so than our native species. The BAF is a bioacoustic fish fence. BAFs use a combination of sound, bubbles, and lights. It broadcasts the sound into a bubble curtain, and so it's a very confined wall of sound, not just broadcasting it out into the water. It's used on the West Coast to help guide salmon and trout migrations, and it's been tested in the lab and in some ponds, but it hasn't been field tested directly in a lock chamber before. Since we already have Asian carp here, we know Asian carp move through that lock chamber, and so we know they'll be challenging that deterrent system. They have done some tests of native fish in laboratories, and it does affect some of them, but not as much as it has the Asian carp.
Asian carp have evolved to where they're very skittish and they will move away from vibrations and or sound. Right now we're going to test here at Barkley to see if this technology works. If it does work, then we're going to debate on where we're going to put them next. Our goal is to stop the upward migration of Asian carp in the Tennessee and Cumberland River systems. We're hoping we can get ahead of this problem.
With Asian carp, there's not really a silver bullet solution. It's our hope that this deterrent system here at Barkley Lock will be effective enough at deterring the Asian carp from moving through there, that with the commercial harvest that we have in Barkley and Kentucky lakes, we will see a significant decrease in their numbers.
I'm pretty optimistic about the future, especially when you consider that commercial harvest is taking millions of pounds of Asian carp out of these lakes this year. That's incredible. The lower the numbers are in these lower reservoirs, that's less pressure for movement to the upper reservoir. Unchecked, we're pretty sure the fish would be further upstream in the system by now, but because we have this system in place, we're thinking we're seeing some progress in that.